In our previous video, we listed the top 3 mobile applications for calorie counting. In the description below, you can find the link to that video. In this video, we are going to introduce more details about the best calorie counting application or list, myfitnesspal. Here, we only focus on available features in the free versions of the app. In the description below, you can find the link to a specific part of this video. To start with, install the app, sign in, and create a profile just as any other apps. Now that the sign up and initial setup is done, I just quickly go through the most important features and settings. As you can see in the home page, you have the calorie budget on the top. You have the target, which is initially set automatically by the app based on your inputs. Here, we have 2010 kilocalories per day, and then you have the food and exercises. Since we haven't added any food or exercises, they are initially set to zero. On the right side, you can see the remaining calories for the day. Let's see how to change the calorie limit. Go to the top left, then to goals, then click on nutrition goals. Here, you can manually change the daily calorie goal and also the macronutrients ratios. For the calorie goal, there are many other tools that can help you to calculate more accurately. Although some reviewers have complained that the automatic suggestion is too low. It might be important to be realistic and not to go for sudden or too difficult plans. The main purpose should be knowing what you eat, how much calories you take and burn, what nutrients you get, and be able to track all these over time. We should think of it as a long-term lifestyle and not just temporary. It might be important to know that to lose weight, you should gain less calories than you burn. It is also important to eat healthy and keep track of macronutrients. The macronutrients percentage depend on your diet choice. Here, the default is based on the standard model. Usually, 45 to 65% of daily calories from carbs, 20 to 35% from fats, and 10 to 35% from proteins. It is good to set the percentage that you know you will stick with. Let's see how to add foods. Click on the plus sign at the bottom right corner, choose food, then choose the category. Let's take the breakfast as an example. There are 3 methods to add your food here. We go through them one by one. The first one is add by barcode. You have the barcode reader on the top right. Click and then scan the barcode. Here, I have a Swedish quark which has high protein. As you see, the product is easily found. You can add the serving amount in different units. Here, I choose the whole container, which is 150 grams. You will also get all the related nutrients automatically. As you see, I get 90 kilocalories and I have the details breakdown of that. Then, on the homepage, you can see that 90 kilocalories is now subtracted from my daily budget and only 1920 calories remain. This is the App Class channel, and if it's your first time here and you want to learn about high-rated apps, start now by subscribing to our channel. Now let's try the second method to add foods. Here, we want to search in the food database. The database is very rich and there are many foods even in different languages. Go to the top and write the name of a food. Here, let's add an egg for breakfast. You see many options pop up. Most of them are similar and they might be added by different users. It's important to choose the one that has the green verified sign. As you see, some of them lack verification and can't be trusted. Once again, after adding the egg, more calories subtracted. You can also use another way to see the food menu. You can either use the plus sign at the bottom right, just as before, or go to the diary section and add it here. Let's use the search method to add some foods for the whole day. Here, I add an apple for breakfast, a complete Big Mac for lunch, a steak for dinner, and a banana for snacks. These are just some examples to show you quickly how simply you can add foods. There is no intention to say these foods are good or healthy. There is a third method to add your food, that is to add it manually. To do this, go to the multi-add on the top right. Here, you can create a food or a complete meal and even share it if you want. It's very easy and you can follow this process. You have a chance to even add macro and micronutrients at the next level. Let me show you first how to add your activity manually. Go to diary, add exercise, and manually add, for example, a 10K run based on my smartwatch recording. That's 60 minutes and 900 calories burnt. Now how to add your exercise app to myfitnesspal to get the burned calories automatically. It's very simple. Go to the main menu on the top left, select apps and devices, find your app, then you need to get connected to it by signing in. That's it. You will be automatically connected. Let's see how to analyze the results. Go to the diary. I will select the 4th of June as an example. Then to the pie chart sign on the top right. As you can see, you can check the calories, macronutrients, protein, fats, and carbs, and macronutrients, vitamins, and minerals on daily or weekly basis. This is a very nice and important feature. It's always good to check if you're missing something important in your weekly diet using this feature. For example, if you find out that you're not taking enough calcium, you could take more foods such as milk or similar with calcium, or if you would like to take some supplements. The macronutrient ratios, vitamins, and minerals are also very important. For minerals and vitamins, you can track on a weekly basis to see if there are any trends or if you always tend to lack any important nutrients in your diet. For macro ratios, it's sometimes recommended to keep balance even on a daily basis. How to track your progress? You can do this by entering your measurement regularly, for example, weekly. You can enter weight and other measurements. Let me show you how. Go to the main menu on the top left, then to progress. Here, you can both see the result over time, and also you can add new measurements. You can also change the graph period. Once again, a very useful feature, available for free, and this app makes it very simple. I have already gone through the most useful features by now. There are more to discover and all available for free, such as many exercises and a lot of recipes which you can read about, learn, and add to your diary. There are many interesting articles that can be informative and inspiring, so there is a lot to discover here. You can join the communities and engage in discussions with other users. As you can see, there are already many users who are active here. You can also try the paid premium version to get more diet and exercise plans, more recipes, more tracking, and data analysis possibilities. But as I said before, this app, even in its free version, is truly the best app on the market and offers a lot of nice features and is very user-friendly. It's continuously improving and today is the most popular one with more than 80 million users. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and if there is anything you want to add, please leave that in the comments below.